Hey everybody, welcome back to the Flink Learning Series. Let's go ahead and get started. So in today's video, we're talking about stateful stream processing. And this is more than just retaining one event at a time and processing that data. We're instead thinking about retaining this data across multiple events. Maybe we need to add that data to a window, like we discussed in the previous video. Or another application of stateful stream processing would be anomaly detection, or detecting patterns in our data. We need to keep track of this data so that we can identify patterns across multiple events. But in today's video, we're going to focus on one specific feature of stateful stream processing called joins. And this would be when you're joining two data sets together. So you can imagine a scenario where you have two separate streams and you want to join the data on a shared ID or shared field. One type of join that we might refer to is called an inner join. And this is what you might expect when it comes to joins, where you're joining data based on the matching events, and only those matching events are emitted onto the stream. If there isn't a matching event, no data is going to be emitted. So a real world scenario where we would apply this is, let's imagine an e-commerce application or set of applications. We might have an orders service where we receive orders from an e-commerce website. And that order service would then emit data based on the orders that were received. It would emit that data downstream to a payment service so that the orders can receive payment. And then it would also emit data to the paid order service for that to do processing later on. But downstream, once that payment has been received, then the application that receives the payment service can then emit its result. And what that kicks off is the process for us to be able to join those two events together, right? We have the orders and we have the payments. The paid order service responsibility is then to join the two data sets together. So if we have order ID 1 and payment for order ID 1, we would join those together and emit the paid order out for further processing. But what do we do if payments for an order never come, or we receive payment for an order that we didn't receive? How do we handle this type of scenario? And much like a database SQL query, we could represent this query against the streams like so. It doesn't have to be complicated. It could be orders O join payments P on O.orderID equals P.orderID. So we're just matching based on the order ID. And it works very similarly in stream processing. So first, if we're looking in the lens of stream processing, let's say first we receive an order ID for order ID 1, we would store that order ID in state. And as new orders come in, we would also store those subsequent orders in state so that we can remember them in case we need to join it with an accompanying payment. So in this scenario, we just received payment for order ID 2. That data would then be linked together, it would be joined, it would be emitted onto that subsequent stream, and then subsequently evicted from state. We can do this because we no longer need to retain that data in state because it's been joined and we're no longer going to make use of it. So let's look at another scenario where we're receiving more orders. We receive order ID 3, and because we have no subsequent payment for that order yet, we're going to store that in application state. Next, we receive payment for order ID 1. And like before, we would join those two events and emit them onto the stream, as well as evict it from state. But state for order ID 3 remains because we haven't found an accompanying join. Now we've received a payment for order ID 4, but we don't have an accompanying order for this payment. So that gets added to application state as well. Now we've received a payment for order ID 3, and the same thing as before happens. We join those two events and we evict it from state. And we're left with the payment for order ID 4, which we do subsequently receive the order, and that will get joined and evicted from state. But what if we never received the matching event for one of those orders? What if order ID 3 never received a payment? Well, that data would actually be retained in application state forever for the duration of the streaming application. And for this small application, this might be okay. But for a larger streaming application where lots and lots of data is coming through, we would want to handle this. And the responsible way to handle this is to evict the data from state once we realize that it's no longer valid or once a particular criteria has been met. A streaming application must manage its state appropriately so that we don't have unbounded state growth, because that can really cause challenges down the line. And the way we can handle this is we must introduce time as a factor to these joins. So let's look at back at the previous example where we have the accompanying payments for all of the orders except for order ID 3. And we can evict these and emit them downstream. What we want to do is we want to say after a certain time period, let's evict this from state. And we would commonly refer to this as state TTL, or time to live. Once this time has elapsed, maybe it's 1 minute, maybe it's 5 minutes, maybe it's 7 days, we can then evict this data from state and be done with it because we don't want to accumulate that state forever. Another way to potentially handle this state growth problem is what we would commonly refer to as interval joins. This is where elements are joined when the matching event arrives within an interval of time. Maybe you're looking back 5 minutes and forward 5 minutes. And if that element falls within that umbrella of time, then you're good. But if it falls out of that time, then we can't use that data. And that's just the way that the interval join would be defined. So what this would look like is, if we had order ID 1 come through, you can see that time represented here, looking back in time and forward in time. When payment for order ID 1 comes in, that falls within the time frame that we're looking for. And so this would be an acceptable join. Next, order ID 2 comes in, and order ID 3 comes in, and right away we get a payment for order ID 3. Within the time frame. But because no matching event came for order ID 2 within the time frame, we would then be able to evict that from state and carry on with our processing. So with that, I want to wrap up today's session. Hopefully this was informative to you. We want to hear your comments. We want to hear your feedback. So leave it in the comments below and stay tuned for the next section, where we're talking about time semantics. Thanks.